as per the Hedgeye quad map, the Q over Q, quarter over quarter, Q3 GDP will be huge. Why there? And be released a few days before the election. Has your DC political group, our policy group, factored this into the election outcome? The timing of this release and the media's focus on Q over Q GDP versus year over year would potentially be a big gift to Trump. Thank you. That's actually an interesting question. And Trump, by the way, has also been narrowing the polls a lot recently. So we're getting back into a bit of a serious race here.
Yeah.
And you know that they're going to do anything they can to print positive economic numbers between now and the election.
There's
question about that.
So to put that in English, slide 13 first, which is what's really happening to the economy. So again, the math on why sequentially it looks better is if you go from down 10 to down 6. Currently around down 6. So you go year over year goes from down 10 to down 6. And that's going to be sequentially better, right? So if you look at the next chart, which shows you the better sequentially, that's already embedded in our assumptions, up 19.7%. So I think when whoever said GDP could be up 20%, you know, they must have been reading our notes.
Sequentially.
Yeah. But again, did the stock market go down because GDP went down? Don't forget there are a lot of reasons why the market can go up. Now, if your question has to, you know, because again, you need a negative 10 to get the most epic amount of central planning in the history of central planning, right? You got Fed balance sheet doubling itself, and now you have the Democrats arguing with the Republicans on splitting the difference between a couple trillion dollars, okay? So again, that's epic cowbell. So if GDP up 20 is the environment that you have, then you really don't need any of the cowbell, right, guys? You gotta take it all away. And let's see what happens when that happens. Dollar would go up, right? Maybe not for a trade. It wouldn't go up because of the quad. And there's a lot to think about, but I certainly wouldn't take my day-to-day. Like, what am I gonna do with that number today? First of all, it's my number, you're reading it. You're telling me a story about how Trump could look better a couple days before the election on one GDP number where he is absolutely gonna trumpet it. Think about it. He's talked about it at a negative 11% unemployment rate being positive.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, so again, I don't think that it's going to change. What changes, it's certainly not going to change the setup that I have from either a signaling perspective or a quad perspective. But it will get more interesting and matter more and more. So maybe another way to ask the question is, Keith, what if the stock market crashes again? Because this is a question I'm asking myself, so I might as well ask myself. I think I have tremendous questions in my head. What if the stock market crashes again between now and September? It would be the right spot because we have the most amount of questions about the short Russell position that I've had since June the 8th. More of the whining type. So let's just say, hey, imagine that. Russell crashes again. Stock market broadly starts to crash. And it crashes like in October, September. You know, stock market crashes, big ones have happened in October. Maybe August, September, October. There's 3 months before that, that GDP number comes up. And then the GDP number comes in, and then Trump says, hey, look, you want it to keep crashing or do you want the economy I created? Maybe Trump does win again. I mean, he's going to be really good in his own mind at changing the narrative. Absolutely will be. He has nothing to do with the next stock market crash because he had nothing to do with the first one. And he'll have everything to do with giving you the recovery because if we don't recover, we're going to keep crashing and it's not going to be because of him.